Hey, this is Digital Byte Computing. Today we're going to talk about the differences between a full backup, an incremental backup, and a differential backup. So you may be working in a company, or you could be just testing or wanting to learn more about this in your own home environment perhaps, and you want to understand the differences between all of them. So we're going to talk about that right after this. All right, so we've got a full backup, a differential, an incremental. What is the difference between each of them? Now, in a normal scenario, I've got a server here. Right, this could be a computer perhaps at home that you set up that you want to have backed up. So that server will have some hard drives plugged into it and you want to back up the data on that. Now, because there's never been a backup done on your server, the first backup that you will perform on that server will always be a full backup. By default, a full backup is every single file that you allocate to be backed up. So if you're, say, on a Windows computer and you've got your C drive and your D drive, and you want to say, I want to back up all of my C and all of my D, the full backup will include every file in a C and a D drive, if that's what you have determined. The incremental backup is then your subsequent backups, perhaps the day after and the day after that and the day after that. Differentials are slightly similar. Now, an incremental backup, the only difference is that you back up the changes from your last incremental backup. So let's explain this. So I've got a server here, all right, with a hard drive, and I've just backed up the contents of that on Monday. All right, this is my first full backup that I have just created. I then will perform another backup on Tuesday. All right, this will be a backup, which is now an incremental backup. Okay, and essentially what's happened here is I've now done a backup on the Tuesday. I've performed the same operation. The only difference being, the incremental backup has now only backed up the changes of those files since the Monday. Now, remembering that the Monday, a full backup was performed, which is a backup of every single file. On the Tuesday, you now have another scheduled backup in place. What that is going to do is that is going to analyze your entire file system, all of the disks and all of the files in that C and in that D, and it'll only back up the changes that have occurred since the last backup. In this case, our last backup is the full. So it's going to interrogate the C drive and it's going to say, look, all of the files are exactly the same except for 10 files. 10 files, somebody has gone in and changed them, or the files have changed themselves. The metadata could be different. The time date stamp could be different. So it's going to identify that file has changed. So it will only back up that file, those files that have changed, okay? So in an incremental, it doesn't need to perform a full backup again. It only will do a backup of the files that have changed since the last full backup, okay? That's an incremental. The day after, I'm now on to Wednesday. Now I'm gonna do another backup. This again will now be an incremental backup if this is the way you've got it configured. Now, this will only back up the files that has changed since the last incremental backup, which is on the Tuesday, okay? It will not care necessarily about the full, it'll only care about what's just happened in the incremental. It will reference the full to make sure that all the files are still there, but it'll only do a backup of the files since the last incremental backup. And then likewise, I've then got Thursday, exactly the same thing. It's going to do an incremental, which is only a copy of the files that have changed since my last incremental, which was the day before. All right, likewise from the day before, likewise from the day before, which my very first full backup happened on that Monday. So if I ever need to do a restore of a file, let's say I know that there's a file that I need to restore from the Wednesday that has changed from the Tuesday, my restore process will go and interrogate my Wednesday and restore that file. If the file hasn't changed on that Wednesday, but it's been deleted and you need to restore it, but it did exist on the Monday, it will do the restore from your full backup. So that is the way an incremental differs from a full backup. Now, what is a good policy to have is a lot of companies will have a full backup that happens, let's say once a week, perhaps on a Friday or on a Saturday, and then you have differentials throughout the day. Because what's gonna happen is if this incremental, which I've set up as an incremental, I wanna do a full backup instead, what it's gonna do is it has to go and back up all of the files all over again. Okay, what does that mean? That means it's a lot more disk space that needs to be used because it has to back up all the files again. As opposed to an incremental, it only needs to do a backup of those four, of those files that have actually changed since the last backup. So your disk size is going to be substantially less if you do incremental backups as opposed to full backups every single day. So now we move on to a differential backup. A differential backup is similar to an incremental backup, but as opposed to referring to the last incremental backup to know the changes that have been made, it's now going to refer back to the last full backup that has been made. And those changes that have changed since the last full backup is what it will back up. Remembering that an incremental backup only backs up the changes since the last incremental, a differential references that full backup every single time. So remember previously for an incremental, I'll perform an incremental backup, and then I'll perform another incremental backup, and this one will only back up the files that have changed since the last incremental backup. Now what we're gonna do is in a differential backup, I'm gonna do a backup here on the Tuesday. Okay, I'm gonna do a backup here on the Wednesday. So a full backup takes place, that's gonna get copied to here. This is now my differential backup. My backup now on the Wednesday will not reference my differential backup from the Tuesday. It'll only reference my full backup. So this will reference my Wednesday, will reference my Monday. And that is my differential backup. So my Tuesdays, because it's a differential, will only back up the files that have changed since my last full. My Wednesday, because it's set up as a differential, will only back up the files that have changed since my full. And then my Thursday will reference my full. Okay? So remembering that with your incrementals, the Wednesday will care about the Tuesday, and the Thursday will care about the Wednesday, that cares about the Tuesday, that cares about the Monday. Now your differentials are all referencing back your full, okay? So in this scenario, it's good to have your full backups fairly frequently. Otherwise, you're gonna keep referencing back to your full, okay? So the good practice would be to have your full backup performed once every week, as well, all right? So you perform it once every week. So let's say Monday, I do my full. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, I do differentials. And then the next Monday, I do my next full. Okay, this is my next Monday. This is Monday 2. This is Monday 1. So the following week, Monday, I now have my differential that'll be referencing this full backup and no longer this full backup.
So if you found that video helpful, please like it and subscribe to my channel, Digital by Computing, just on the button there for more videos.